Now members, let us see classes with unequal class intervals. This happens when you see that the class width from one class to another changes. So under such conditions, to obtain mode, we use the frequency density or the standard frequency. The class with the highest value of the standard density or the standard frequency becomes the model class. But the question is, what is the standard, frequency density? This is the ratio of frequency of a given class to the width of that class, i.e. if the class has frequency f and the width is c, so the standard density, the frequency density is f of c. Then the frequency density, this is the format we are meaning, frequency density over the class width. Then the standard frequency, this is obtained by dividing frequency with the number of times the standard class interval goes into the class interval of that frequency. The standard interval is a common interval as a frequency and calculations. Note, histogram of unequal classes is plotted with the frequency density or standard density or standard frequency against class boundaries, as we are going to see an example there. So let us see how we calculate the standard frequency and also the frequency density. So use the table below to calculate the frequency density and the standard frequency and hence the model class. Find the model class. So this is what we are having. We have these classes. We are saying these are bounded classes, by the way. Because this is the same, 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 this is the same. It's the same. So here, I think we say we are going, but there are going to see more examples about this in the next lesson. So, after doing this, now we get our standard frequency. So, now that my classes are here, then how do we get the frequency? The frequency is given already there. Now, from here, what is going to happen is the classes, you say this minus, because these are now class boundaries, because these are the same. So, you just subtract this from this, you get this from this, then this from this, then. This from this, then 20. This from this, get this, then this from this, you get 20. Now, our class frequency density is given by the frequency divided by this. So, this divided by this, we get 0.1. This divides this, we get 0.2. 0.5. 0.6. There we get 13 divided by 5 divided by 60, 30, we get 0.17 to 2 decimal places. Then this one we get 0.2. Yeah, 0.2. And then we say the class with the highest T. The class with the highest T, where is it? The class with the highest value. The highest value of the frequency density becomes the mode. So it's that this is the highest value we have, this one here. So meaning that now our mode class is going to be model class is going to be 30 to 40. Why? It's that the one with the highest frequency density, this is the class, and that's the corresponding class. Okay, now from there we come now to standard frequency. Standard frequency, the first part is the same, frequency is the same, and then we have here the class boundaries. But now, here the number of times, how many the number of times, what we do, we get the common class interval or the frequent class interval. It's that 10 is the one that appears most, as we say here. Standard class interval is the common interval or appears most times. You see that here 10 appears most times. Now, what you do, this 10 now, you get this 10 and divide through all these classes here. So 10 divides, the common now is 10. So 10 divides 10, 1. Divide by 10, 1. Divide by 10, 1. This divide by 10, we get 2. Here we get 3, here we get 2. So you get the common class, we divide it by all classes. Then you get our n. Now to get the standard frequency, you get this n, you divide it with the that. So this divides this. Now you get f over n. This is our n. So n divides f, we get 1. 1 divided by this, we get 2. Then 1 divides f, we get 5. Then we have 2 divides this, we get 6. Then 3 divides this. I think that's regarding the small 1.8. Here we get 1.67. Then 2 divides this, we get a 2. I think now we see that now the class with the highest standard frequency. This is the class with the highest standard frequency. And you see it's corresponding to 30, 50. So model class will be 30 to 50. That will be our answer. So that's the difference between the other one and then getting the standard frequency. As simple as that. I think you can, if you are careful, you can note the relationship between this. And then this, you can just look at this and this, and this is what they did. This is what we did with these ones now. So that's members. Now we are going to see how do we draw a histogram for unequal classes. See you in the next lesson.